down, all the demons creeping in. Oh, another round, trading shots with my ego. Running can't tell me now. Your chains only drag me down.
It's time to stand up, show me what you're made of.
Track Masters Cup Series in the second race of Season 2, the Aflac 500 at the Atlanta Motor Speedway. I'm your host, Jonathan. Weather today, another perfect Saturday afternoon for racing action at Atlanta, and Kyle Larson will be starting on the pole. He'll lead the field to green later today. But Larson's going to have to fight off 29 other drivers if he hopes to take the checkered flag, and among those drivers is Ryan Newman, the Season 2 Daytona 500 winner and the current points leader. Hopes to hold on to his points lead, but he'll have to fight his way to the front of the field as he's starting mid-pack. In Season 1, Jamie McMurray was able to take the checkered flag at Atlanta. He might not be racing anymore, but his teammate Kyle Larson sure is, and he's starting on the pole for tonight's Aflac 500 and was fastest in Friday's practice. However, Kyle Larson isn't the only young driver hoping for a win. Daniel Hemric is also chasing after the checkered flag today. Started second in the 500, but wrecked out on lap 3 with Ryan Preece and Eric Jones, so he's looking to take the checkered flag today and rebound from a disappointing finish at Daytona. We've been talking a lot about these young drivers, but how about a more seasoned veteran, Kevin Harvick? He won Atlanta in 2018 and had a strong performance in 2017. Harvick is looking to take the checkered flag today as his first win of Season 2. Let's not forget about, though, Ryan Newman, the current series points leader and the Daytona 500 winner. He's starting deep in the field. He'll have to work his way towards the front if he hopes to keep his elusive points lead. All these drivers and more have a chance to prevail in the Aflac 500, but only one will come out on top, and it's Atlanta, so you'll have to learn it. Don't go anywhere. The NASCAR Trackmasters Cup Series will be right back after this. NASCAR and TMG. Most of the pre-race ceremonies have been concluded, but there's still one more we need to do. We need to hand it trackside for the command to fire engines.
Drivers, start your engines!
Engines roar to life in front of this sold-out crowd at Atlanta Motor Speedway as we move in for your starting lineup. So on the pole for today, we got Kyle Larson starting to the inside of Martin Truex Jr., and in row 2, Brad Keselowski to the inside of Daniel Hemric. Row 3 houses Kevin Harvick to the inside of the Flash winner Eric Almirola, and in row 4, Ryan Preece to the inside of Kyle Busch. Row 5 goes to Jimmy Johnson to the inside of Ryan Blaney, and in row 6, we have Chase Elliott to the inside of Clint Bowyer. Now coming up in row 7, we have Kurt Busch to the inside of Joey Logano, and following them in row 8 is Eric Jones to the inside of Alex Bowman. Row 9 belongs to Daytona 500 winner Ryan Newman to the inside of Austin Dillon, and coming up in row 10, it's the 41 car of Daniel Suarez to the inside of Chris Buescher. Row 11 goes to the 95 car of Matthew Benedetto and Denny Hamlin, and in row 12, we have Ricky Stenhouse Jr. to the inside of Drake Mays. Row 13 goes to William Byron and Paul Menard, and row 14 goes to Ty Dillon to the inside of Parker Ness. Now rounding out the field in row 15, it's Bubba Wallace to the inside of Michael McDowell. They will be the last to take the green flag in the Aflac 500. Speaking of the green flag, pole sitter Kyle Larson is getting ready to take that green flag as he comes off turn 4. Green flag is in the air at the Aflac 500. We're underway. Kevin Harvick to the outside of Brad Keselowski, now moving on in for second place. Harvick clear of Keselowski for second. Here comes Priest back up the inside. Priest and Keselowski will go side-by-side for third as Harvick is gaining on Larson. Almost got side-by-side with him through there. Not going to happen. Larson leads down the back. Harvick now is going to capitalize on Larson getting loose and takes the lead on lap three. Harvick clear of Larson as they head to lap three. Fly by the field here as they come through turn one and two. Big move by Johnson up the outside of Hemric, and we got trouble. Joey Logano loses an engine down the back straightaway. Caution comes out on lap three for the first time today. Not too much of a replay. Just looks like Joey Logano's engine blew coming off of turn number four, pulled it down on the apron, and that will be the end of his day and the hopes to rebound in the point standing scene as he had a bad showing at Daytona. So Joey Logano, the first car out at Atlanta, as we're going to go to commercial break. We'll be right back after this. Welcome back to the Aflac 500 at the Atlanta Motor Speedway. We're coming up on a restart on lap 5 of 10. Kevin Harvick will be leading the field to green, followed by Kyle Larson and Ryan Preece. Here they come off turn 4. Green flag is back in the wind at Atlanta. Good restart by Kevin Harvick. Ryan Preece is going to follow him through. Now Preece crosses over to the inside. We got trouble. Martin Truex Jr.'s around. Collects Keselowski. A two-car pile up on the back straightaway. Caution comes out right after the restart on lap 5. And Roger Penske's day goes from bad to worse as Keselowski, another one of his drivers, is collected in this crash. You'll see here Keselowski trying to go up high on Truex. Didn't realize the 19 was still there and got him into the wall. Keselowski went down low to clear him, and Truex went right back into him. Tagged Keselowski in the right rear and sent Keselowski up into the wall. A vicious hit by the two-car Johnson, barely able to avoid it. And yeah, this two-car pileup taking two more heavy hitters out of the race. Don't go anywhere. NASCAR and TMG will be right back after this. Welcome back to the Atlanta Motor Speedway. We are getting ready for a restart. Here's your top five. Ryan Preece leading the way, followed by Kevin Harvick, Kyle Larson, Eric Almirola, and Jimmy Johnson. A huge rebound by Ryan Preece from last week when he got involved in a wreck. But with all these hard chargers coming from behind, I doubt he'll be able to hold them off for very long. But we'll have to find out. Green flag back in the air from Atlanta. Ryan Preece leads him down. Harvick using that side draft on the outside. It's going to get him up the outside. Here comes Larson up the inside. Larson washes up the racetrack. Almirola takes advantage and sweeps around the outside. Side by side for third. Stewart Haas Racing runs 1-2 down the back straightaway. Eric Almirola gaining on Harvick as they go into 3 and 4. The white flag might be waving, but the race has just begun. Almirola to the inside of Harvick. He'll clear Harvick going into turn 1 and 2. With only a set of corners to go, Harvick's out of luck and out of time. Eric Almirola wheels it off turn 4, and he's going to take the checkered flag at Atlanta. Eric Almirola, the early season momentum continues. He won the clash, and now he wins at Atlanta. Let's take a look at the move of the race. You'll see here coming to one lap to go, Eric Almirola has closed in on Harvick. He's at the bumper. All he needs to do then was go to the inside and get Harvick going in a 1 and 2. And gap Harvick enough so that he couldn't chase him back down. So Eric Almirola burns it down on the front stretch. Well, he won the clash and now he won the Aflac 500, so it's clear to me that Eric Almirola will be one of the championship favorites. But I digress, let's look at the top 10. So coming in with the victory today, obviously, is Eric Almirola, followed by Kevin Harvick, Ryan Preece, Kyle Larson, Ryan Blaney, Jimmy Johnson, Daniel Hemric, Kyle Busch, Alex Bowman, and Ryan Newman rounds out the top 10. So some notable finishes, Paul Menard and Bubba Wallace really impressive today with the 13th and 16th respectively, while Denny Hamlin, William Byron, Drake Mays, and Parker Ness really fell off a cliff from last week at Daytona. We'll see if they can rebound, but we'll go ahead and take a look at your top 12 in points. Ryan Newman still holding on to the top spot, followed by Jimmy Johnson, Kyle Larson, Kurt Busch, William Byron, Denny Hamlin, Eric Almirola, Clint Bowyer, Matt DiBenedetto, Paul Menard, Ryan Preece, and Chase Elliott round out the top 12. You might be wondering why we're focusing on the top 12. Well, keep in mind that in the Trackmasters Cup Series, the top 10 is what gets you into the playoffs, not wins. 11th and 12th are the current wildcard spots because no one outside the top 10 has won a race. Anyways, the next race will be the Pennzoil 400 at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. But until then, this is the Motorsports Guy signing off. I'll see you at Las Vegas.